Bob Maloney for MyMMAnews.com, and I am talking to Dylan Mantello, the quiet man. Dylan, my man, how you feeling? It's fight week.
Feeling good. Feeling very good. Clicking on all cylinders right now. You know, all the work's been put in. Now it's just time to let the body recover and get sharp and get my mind right for combat and finish the weight cut. And, you know, I'm always ready. I'm always ready to get in there and fight when I have the work put in. So feeling good.
Well, before we listen, I know it's weight cut and it's been a grind. So before we let's take your mind off of the fight for a couple of minutes. And the Quiet Man, the movie, your nickname is your nickname from the movie. Tell me a little bit about that. I mean, we had talked briefly about the movie before. Was there any connection?
Yeah, I mean, that was a movie that that I watch every year with my dad, actually. So it's you know, I kind of use that as a tribute to him. You know, he's still alive, obviously, but it's a special bond that I share with him. You know, it's about a boxer who was in Pittsburgh and he winds up killing a man in the ring, and he you know, for prize fighting, and he realizes that, you know, he needs to run away from fighting and get away from it. And he moves to Ireland, tries to run away from his problems, but he realizes that once he gets there, that, you know, he needs to be fighting for different reasons, and he needs to be fighting for the people that he care about. And I think that that's, you know, a good analogy for my life. You know, when I was younger, I was getting a lot of street fights. You know, anybody kind of looked at me the wrong way, it was kind of just, you know, it ended up being a scrap in the street and stuff. And it's just, that's no way to live. So I found martial arts, and, you know, it really changed my life. And, now, you know, I have all that rage, and I have all that, you know, determination now is channeled in the right, way. And, you know, it's been good for me. It's been good for my family. So my dad wasn't necessarily on board when I started training and when I started fighting. You know, I went to college. He wanted me to go get a real job and do all that stuff. And, you know, it's admirable for a parent to say, and I understand that, but sometimes you have to cut your own way. And, you know, after he see me put in the hard work and have success in the cage, you know, he got behind me full, you know, all the way. And, you know, now we go at these fights together, and I have his full support, and it means the world to me.
Hey, listen, you know from how much that means to you, from your dad and like your team, you know, you guys are like, you know, I really tight team, really good team. Talk to me a little bit, because you got guys in camp with you right now as well. So how has this camp been winding down? Because there's a bunch of you guys that are, you know, all getting ready to step into the cage.
Yeah, we just went 4-1 or 5-1 last weekend. Got a bunch of finishes, you know, so we have another six guys on this card. We have Christian Acerbo, you know, Lauren Brachia, Damian Nelson, me, James Gonzalez, and Dennis Bazooka, all going in on Friday. Three of those are for titles, too. Three of them are for belts. So we're looking to bring home some hardware this time. And, you know, my first title fight, those two guys are defending their belts. So we're very excited. We put in the work together. You know, we're a family, we're a team, you know, so we're all prepared, and we're looking forward to a really good night. I think the whole team is coming up together now at a good time, and we're all peaking in our careers where we're now on the cusp of, you know, getting the national attention. And I think a lot of us are going to be coming on the scene at the same time, which is great, because we all get to share it together. And there's no, you know, there's no animosity, there's no jealousy, any kind of stuff like that. We're all just aimed in the right direction together. And when you get that many like-minded people and determined people going the right way and all in the same direction and helping each other, really good things happen. And I just got to give a shout out to Ray Longo. I mean, he's the head honcho. He's the godfather of the team, and he's the silent master. You know, he kind of runs everything behind the scenes. And, you know, we take after his example, and we're looking forward to it.
Hey, he's a legend in a sport, man, Ray Longo. You know what I mean? And if anything, you need advice or anything on the other side of fighting, you have guys that have been doing it for a long time and have helped other guys get to the peak of the sport. Before we go, Dylan Buss, once again, Dylan is taking on John Ramirez Friday the 22nd in Atlantic City, New Jersey at the show. In the showroom at the Tropicana, I'll be cage side. Dylan is looking to go 5-0. John Ramirez, listen, Dylan, you've been a fireball lately. You've been killing it. Is this fight gonna? Your last two fights didn't make it out of the first round. You know, John Ramirez has more experience than you. He's been in there. He's been in some tough fights. Is this fight gonna get out of the first round?
We'll see what he's got. I'm prepared for three rounds, but I'm trying to take my opponent out every second of every round. So whether it's the first round, second round, third round, it's the same energy. I'm in there to take you out. And, you know, he has more experience than me. I think he has, you know, 16, 17 fights altogether, 10 professional fights. And he's never been finished. So I have to take that in consideration. He's fought some tough guys. He went up and fought at 170 for Ring Combat for the belt against Troy Green, and he went the distance with him. So, you know, I'm not writing him off, and I think that he's a worthy opponent for me. He's a southpaw. He's athletic. I think he works hard. He's a young guy, so he's still growing as a fighter. So I'm thinking I have my hands full, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's a first round finish either, because I'm working hard every single day, and I have the skills, and I have the coaches, and I have the teammates to make a big splash in this sport. So he's next, you know, he's next for the title for me. And, you know, I'm going to go do what I do, and I'm going to go take him out and get a belt wrapped around my waist and celebrate with my family and my team, and look for what's next. Cause I think either Contender Series or some of the other bigger promotions are going to be looking my way, and I'm ready for that challenge as well. So anybody, anytime, anywhere, that's the motto. So let's do it.
Well, Dylan, it's a pleasure, you know, following you through your journey. I appreciate you giving me some time each fight. And like I said, when you move on to bigger and better things, I look forward to telling that story as well. Like you said, you know, Contender Series, you've seen more and more people with 5-6 fights get on there. You know, ring. You know that Lou talks to Dana White all the time, so I'm sure he'll be pushing you. And, you know, you've been finishing spectacularly. It's a pleasure watching you, pleasure talking to you. I'll see you at the Tropicana, man. Great talking to you again.
Absolutely. Thank you for the time. Appreciate it. I'll see you down there. I'll see you in the winner's circle. Thank you.